Good morning and welcome. We'll begin with the Lo, We Are Christians.
We are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord. We are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord. And alone we are Christians by our love.
Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Today we gather to celebrate the conversion of St. Paul. And as we do that, we recognize the need for conversion in all of our lives. So let us pause for a moment, opening our hearts to conversion as we seek our Lord's mercy and forgiveness for our sins. Lord Jesus, you are the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are our Redeemer. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, Son of Mary, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who taught the whole world through the preaching of the blessed Apostle Paul, draw us, we pray, nearer to you through the example of him whose conversion we celebrate today, and so make us witnesses to your truth in the world. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Saul, still breathing murderous threats against the disciples of the Lord, went to the high priest and asked him for letters to the synagogues in Damascus, that if he should find any men or women who belonged to the way, he might bring them back to Jerusalem in chains. On his journey, as he was nearing Damascus, a light from the sky suddenly flashed around him. He fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to him, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" He said, "Who are you, sir?" The reply came, "I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting. Now get up and go into the city, and you will be told what you must do." The men who were traveling with him stood speechless, for they heard the voice, but could see no one. Saul got up from the ground, but when he opened his eyes, he could see nothing. So they led him by the hand and brought him to Damascus. For 3 days he was unable to see, and he neither ate nor drank. There was a disciple in Damascus named Ananias, and the Lord said to him in a vision, "Ananias." He answered, "Here I am, Lord." The Lord said to him, "Get up and go to the street called Straight, and ask at the house of Judas for a man from Tarsus named Saul. He is there praying, and in a vision, he has seen a man named Ananias come in and lay his hands on him, that he might regain his sight." But Ananias replied, "Lord, I have heard from many sources about this man, what evil things he has done to your holy ones in Jerusalem. And here he has authority from the chief priests to imprison all who call upon your name." But the Lord said to him, "Go, for this man is a chosen instrument of mine to carry my name before Gentiles, kings, and children of Israel. And I will show him what he will have to suffer for my name." So Ananias went and entered the house, laying his hands on him. He said, "Saul, my brother, the Lord has sent me, Jesus, who appeared to you on the way by which you came, that you may regain your sight and be filled with the Holy Spirit. Immediately, things like scales fell from his eyes, and he regained his sight. He got up and was baptized, and when he had eaten, he recovered his strength. He stayed some days with the disciples in Damascus, and he began at once to proclaim Jesus in the synagogues, that he is the Son of God. All who heard him were astounded and said, "Is not this the man who in Jerusalem ravaged those who call upon his name and came here expressly to take them back in chains to the chief priests?" But Saul grew stronger and confounded the Jews who lived in Damascus, proving that this is the Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
Praise the Lord, all you nations. Glorify him, all you peoples.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
For steadfast is his kindness toward us, and the fidelity of the Lord endures forever.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
Jesus appeared to the 11 and said to them, "Go into the whole world and proclaim the gospel to every creature. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. Whoever does not believe will be condemned. These signs will accompany those who believe. In my name, they will drive out demons. They will speak new languages. They will pick up serpents with their hands, and if they drink any deadly thing, it will not harm them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they will recover." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Brothers and sisters, good morning.
Good morning.
As we gather today in worship and praise of our Heavenly Father, yes, we come to celebrate as well the conversion of St. Paul the Apostle. There is a focus today in our scripture readings on the saving gospel and our integration of God's divine word into our very being and is present with us, within us, all the days of our lives. In our reading from the Acts of the Apostles, we hear of Paul, also known as Saul. He's a Jew. He's a rabbi from Tarsus. He had received his rabbinic training from Gamaliel in Jerusalem. He was a strict Pharisee who was persecuting the Christians, of which many he had imprisoned. The beginning of the reading found Saul still breathing threat and murder against the Lord's disciples. He stood there while Stephen was stoned to death, and he held other people's garments so they could throw stones at Stephen. Saul was then on the road to Damascus in Syria to get more of those Christians who he then would take back to Jerusalem. He then came to have an experience of the risen Lord, which changed his life forever. And the risen Lord had called out to him, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" Saul asked, "Who are you, Lord?" Jesus responded, "I am Jesus, the Nazarene." A great light from heaven then came to shine down upon Saul, who had been fallen to the ground. It was a life-changing experience for Saul, as he then took three long missionary journeys proclaiming the Torah-free gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. To momentarily reflect on our very experiences of life and in faith, we've all experienced moments when we have found ourselves rethinking something we have done, or maybe something we should have done, and we make a decision to correct such actions or inactions in our very, very lives. Yes, we all have experienced such moments when the Lord has truly called out to us and has spoken. And I know that the Lord has spoken to you. Yes, they are life-changing moments for us as well. In our gospel reading today from Mark, the reading is referred to the longer ending of the gospel, for it goes beyond the normal verse 8. It speaks of Jesus following his resurrection on the very first day of the week, who then appeared first to Mary Magdalene, who then reported to those who had journeyed with Jesus, and they were gathered together, all mourning and weeping in the experience of Jesus having been crucified. It speaks also of Jesus then having appeared in another form to those who were walking on the road to Emmaus, a story which we are all aware, and then of Jesus appearing to the other disciples who were all gathered at table and telling them to go out into the world to proclaim the gospel, and whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. Pope Francis had declared the third Sunday in Ordinary Time as the Sunday of the Word in the proclamation and in our hearing. God's divine word, we are truly bolstered and supported in our daily lives in the continuation as well of our journey in faith. How truly blessed we are to gather here this morning to come to hear of God's divine word, which speaks to all of us. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.
Our needs and prayers will be spoken to our God, trusting in his care.
For our upright bishops and humble priests among church leaders, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For fearless preachers and wise teachers of the good news, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For inspired confessors and patient guides for the faithful, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For gentle healers and spiritual physicians to accompany the sick, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For faithful companions and honest friends to share the road of life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Joe and Clara friends, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For beloved departed and unknown saints welcomed into God's light, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heard into this pandemic for a vaccine as it rolls out for all people, for healing for those who are sick, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Together we pray through the intercession of St.
In our family relationships, may we find healing and seek to be holy. May our fathers help us to become faithful disciples of Jesus, who share our love for him. As foster father of Jesus, watch over all who serve as spiritual fathers. In a special way, bless our Holy Father, our Bishop, and our priests. May they follow your humble example in their fatherly care for the people of God and the Church.
With Mary, who
raised Jesus to the high priest, you know our need for priests. Please raise up good and holy priests from our families to serve the people of our diocese. May our children and grandchildren hear and say yes to the call of Jesus, just as you and Mary did.
Good Saint Joseph, pray for us.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through you, as we receive this bread we offer you, food to the earth, work of human hands, that you become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through you, as we receive this wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, that you become for us our spiritual drink. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept our sacrifice for the praise and glory of His name, for our honor and glory to all your holy church.
As we celebrate the divine mysteries, O Lord, we pray, may the Spirit fill us with the light of faith, with which you constantly enlightened the blessed Apostle Paul for the spreading of your glory. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you, Eternal Shepherd, do not desert your flock, but through the blessed apostles, watch over it and protect it always, so that it may be governed by those you have appointed shepherds to lead it in the name of your Son. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, to without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. Giving thanks, he said a blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out
for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, David our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with Blessed Paul and all the blessed apostles, with Saint Francis of Assisi, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we might merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, formulated by teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us turn and acknowledge those who are above us.
Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are they who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
please pray with us now the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. In the sacrament we have received, O Lord our God, stir up in us that fire of charity with which the blessed Apostle Paul burned ardently as he bore his concern for all the churches. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Line 8 is last night at the night mass regarding the football game yesterday. Packers are going to the playoffs, are going to the Super Bowl. We're just not going this year. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.